innocent. I ain't ashamed to be white. I ain't ashamed to be black. I ain't ashamed of my beautiful Mexican wife.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome. My name is Laura, if you do not know. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about popular YA books that I have no interest in reading. I thought this would kind of be an interesting thing to talk about on my channel because there are so many books that are just so hyped and everybody reads them. But then there's like the small majority of people that are just like, I'm good. I don't want to read that. And I kind of want to talk about those books that I'm the small majority for. And then you guys can let me know in the comments if you agree or disagree with me. Or maybe there's a book that you kind of feel that way about where like you're that small majority of people that doesn't want to read it. So let me know down below, of course, obviously. But I have all of the books listed on my phone here. So I'm just going to get started and share the books that I'm not interested in reading with you. Starting out kind of controversial, the first book on my list is Divergent by Veronica Roth. The whole series, I guess, I'm just not interested in reading. I did see the movies, and they were all right. I have no interest in reading this book or the following books after it. I thought the movies were, like, okay, so I really would not want to read the book, even if they're so much better. And also, I got spoiled on how the whole trilogy ends, because everybody was spoiled, I feel like. So, yeah, I just have no interest in reading Divergent. I know it's some people's, like, absolute favorite book, like I know, but I have no interest in that book. Next on my list is Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. Now this book was like all the hype when it came out because it's sort of like a sub book off of Fangirl, and Fangirl is one of my favorite books, so it might come as a little bit of a shock that I'm not interested in Carry On, but I'm just not into that kind of book. I guess it's sort of like lightly based off of like a Harry Potter-esque type of book. I don't want to like say words that aren't accurate, so if that's not true at all, my bad. But yeah, I just have no interest in reading it. I know so many people like love that book and cherish it, and yeah, I like Rainbow Rowell. I have no interest in reading Carry On. Next on my list is Red Queen by Victoria Aveyard, which I also believe is a series. My reason for not wanting to read this comes from the fact that it has such mixed reviews. Like, you either hear about people absolutely loving it or people absolutely hating it. And because I'm not really, like, too interested in the book as is, I just have no interest in reading a book that has so many negative reviews. So, yeah, I probably will not be reading Red Queen or any of the books that follow it. Yeah. Next book on my list is Carve the Mark by Veronica Roth, and my reason for not wanting to read this comes from a huge controversy that was going on a few months ago on BookTube about this book and the problems with it, and just overall, I hate this word, but how it's problematic. And so for that reason, I will refrain from reading Carve the Mark. Not that I was that interested in reading it beforehand, but just knowing now that there's so many people that are really offended by this book and that it's just, no, like, don't read this book, don't support the book. I'm not going to be, so yeah, that's on my list. Next up on my list is The Fifth Wave by Rick Yancey. That book and the sequel or sequels, I'm not really sure. I just really have no interest in reading this book. I believe it's about like aliens coming to the earth or something. I just have no interest. I kind of feel like I'm really far behind on the bandwagon anyway because everybody talked about that book like forever ago. So just overall, I feel like if I tried to read it now anyway, nobody would really be that hype about it because everybody read it like 3 years ago. So yeah, I don't really have an interest in reading The Fifth Wave. Next on my list is The Maze Runner or The Maze Runner series by James Dashner. This one I actually saw the first movie for and I did enjoy it, but it's just something that I never would find myself reading. Like, I would never really be interested in that book, especially because I've heard a lot of people say that it's actually sort of boring. I know that my brother read the series and he seemed to like it, but I also had a friend that read the series and she hated it, so there again with kind of like the mixed reviews. If somebody says a book is boring, I will probably find it boring, especially if it's not a contemporary, because I tend to get a bit lost in like dystopian and sci-fi books. So yeah, I just don't think that The Maze Runner is for me, but to each their own. Next book on my list is The Spectacular Now by Tim Tharp. This is a book that isn't really as popular as all of the ones I've previously mentioned, but I thought I would throw it in there because I saw The Spectacular Now movie because it has two of my favorite people in it, Shailene Woodley and Miles Teller. Absolutely love both of them. But the movie was quite boring and I just really didn't like it. It's sort of like a coming of age story, but it just fell a little flat for me. And after hearing from one of my best friends that the movie is actually better than the book, I no longer was interested in reading the book. So yeah, there's that. I just don't think that book sounds very good considering the movie wasn't that great either, which I know you shouldn't judge one based on the other, but I just overall think I would not enjoy that book, so yeah. And I've just never really heard anybody rave about the book, so that kind of shows for itself that it just might not be all that good, so I will not be reading the spectacular now. Next up is Beautiful Creatures by Kami Garcia. This is a series that, again, I've heard sort of mixed reviews on. I think it's 4 books. I think there might have been a movie. I'm really not sure, but I just have no interest in reading this series, and I know it's kind of popular, so I thought I would throw it in. There's really no particular reason other than the fact that it doesn't appeal to me, so yeah, I probably will not be reading that series. Next up on my list is Ready Player One, which I actually think isn't a YA book. It's an adult book, but we'll just keep it in the video. This book has been getting so much attention recently because the trailer for the movie just came out, so everyone's kind of like re-hyping it because this book was super hype on BookTube like 2 or 3 years ago or something. And I wasn't interested in it back then, and I'm not interested in it now. The concept sounds really cool. I'm not even gonna lie about that. Like, the idea of this guy going into a video game sounds really sick, cool, like, yeah. But I just personally know that I will not enjoy that book. It just doesn't sound like a book that's for me. So I'm not saying that I'm not gonna read it because it's a bad book, because that's not why. It just doesn't sound like something I would personally be interested in reading. It's not because I've heard it's bad or anything, because I've only heard great things about the book. So yeah, I guess it's just a personal preference that I don't want to read it. But yeah, that's on my list. And the last one on my list of books that I will never pick up is Graceling and the other books that kind of follow with it, like Bitter Blue, I think, is one of them. I think there's one that's like Fire or something. And again, I'm not reading this book just because I've heard so many mixed reviews on it. Some people say it's great. Some people say it's just really boring. And again, if a book's boring, I really can't get into it, especially if it's like a dystopian or a sci-fi or something like that. This book, I believe, is about children that are graced with certain powers and stuff, and that sounds really cool, but I just don't think I would personally be into that anyway, so I'm not planning on reading that series either. So those are all of the books on my list of popular YA books that I do not plan on reading. I hope I didn't break too many of your hearts or make too many of you guys upset because I won't read your favorite books. I'm really sorry. But let me know down below what books you're never gonna read, if you agree with any of these, or if I just kind of talked about one of your favorite books and you're really mad at me right now. Like, I'm sorry, it's okay. But in the meantime, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below if you've not already. I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will talk to you in the next one. Bye. I've been feeling so down. I think they should know now. I think they should know what's up. That's that road I've been down. I know how it go down.